There's something spooky about this dimension. I mention this corner of YouTube land. It's called the Antiverse, full of kingdoms, of epic colonies of ants. But tonight, something's coming to this Antiverse room. This Dracula ant colony's brewing, unsuspecting what's coming to their quiet little ant tower called Blood Tower. It might be their best hour or doom. AC family, come and join us on this Halloween episode. An epic ant story of these ants that are thirsty for the blood of their babies. It's the Dracula Ant Musical.
Enjoy.
Once upon a time, in the Antiverse, there was a kingdom of Dracula ants that lived within an ant tower called the Blood Tower. Have you heard of the Dracula ant? These insects are so different. Bet you've never seen something this abhorrent. Enter the Dracula ants. They seem like caring ants to their larvae. They let the young feed first, oh, how sweet. But there's a reason to this methodology of these Dracula ants. You see, when the larvae have had their fill, the workers take them down into the anthill. Now that the larvae are fat as hell, their hemolymph is rich as well. Hemolymph is the term for ant blood, and this species is a bit of a cannibal because they drink the hemolymph of their own larvae. It's pretty crazy, wouldn't you say, AC family?
With their long mandibles, they make small shallow holes into the larvae and cocoons, drinking the hemolymph. Ew, it's how blood-sucking ants are nourished. Their young's blood is their main food.
This colony of Dracula ants grew in size since we saw them last. Doing real well, they're an ant success.
Loving these Dracula ants.
Let's feed them a roach freshly killed. Watch this, AC family, they will carry their larvae off the ant hill.
Feeding time for Dracula ants.
Oh, and by the way, this Dracula ant colony needs a name. So let's name them, shall we? Please take a moment to vote here for their official name from your name suggestions in a previous video. Thank you, AC Council, for naming these larvae filling, skin cutting, blood sucking,
Dracula ants!
Now, Dracula ants are certainly cool, but what I found cooler is that, unlike most ants, rumor had it that they show no extra colony aggression. Meaning, if we were to mix two unrelated Dracula ant colonies together, they would not fight, but instead join forces. And this is a very good thing, an advantage in the ant world, if your species can form super colonies with other colonies. Why, you ask? How would an ant colony benefit by joining forces with another ant colony? Well, it's simple.
The more ants there is, the longer they live. There's several reasons that ants benefit. More colony members means more ants are fed. Cause more worker force means more food collected. Yes, just imagine this, AC fam. If we were not 2.3 million fans, we couldn't do much to hit algorithms to make these ant videos trend to no end. Well, ants are the same. To win the game, they must grow quick as they possibly can. Like when it rains, more have to transport the brood and the queen. Say what? The colony's big. More workers have to take care of the kids. If enemies hit, more workers help them have good defense.
More ants means more tunnels, which means much more space to manage garbage, bathroom areas, larvae rooms, egg rooms, cocoon rooms, dry rooms, wet rooms, sleeping rooms, rooms of all kinds. Decisions can be made faster. And speaking of which, the number one reason a big colony increases the chances of them surviving is cause with more ants all communicating, the smarter they are collectively speaking. A single ant's message can spread virally, like hey, there's a cockroach just over this bridge. It would take much longer to find it if they were just a small ant colony of say 8. And so you see, joining two ant colonies that are known to not show intercolony aggression can be a good thing. And it just so happens, I had another Dracula ant colony with which I intended for them to join forces.
This big operation is gonna be crazy. Dracula ant introduction of two ant colonies. This big operation is gonna be crazy. Dracula ant introduction of two ant colonies. This big operation is gonna be crazy. Dracula ant introduction of two ant colonies. This big operation is gonna be crazy. Dracula ant introduction of two ant colonies.
Here we go! But before I was going to connect this new larger ant colony with our young ant colony, I just wanted to test and make sure there wouldn't be a battle royale from the introduction, just in case the rumors weren't true. So to do that, I had to introduce members from one colony to the other colony, and vice versa, to see if the workers would attack each other. It was an experiment I felt good about and needed to try. I was nervous, but I had to do this. But were the rumors true? I had to know, I had to try. But if this worker dies, my conscience will haunt me. Should I change my mind? But in the name of science, this would be the perfect instance of how these Dracula ants can engage in colony fusion. It's amazing, not all species of ants can do this. Don't you guys wanna see this happen? I'm interested, pop the lid open with my tweezers, pick up one ant and pull it out, then I shall drop it. I must see this with my own two eyes. Let's do this, AC family. Let's try dropping the Dracula ant in. I'm sorry. Peculiar. Awesome. Untouched. Unscathed. Accepted by the foreign colony. This is awesome. So the rumors aren't just rumors, it's actually true. Our beloved Dracula ants are willing to accept unrelated members in the ant tower. Time to try adding one of their members into the other container to see if the same thing will happen. If so, we can introduce them. Something tells me they'll accept this foreign stranger. And yes, if this ends up happening, that's when we can go and fuse them into a super colony of Dracula ants to live as one big kingdom and have a mighty Dracula ant colony. AC family, wish me luck, let's go and dive in. I'm invested, pop the lid open with my tweezers, pick up one ant and pull it out, then I shall drop it. I must see this with my own two eyes. Dropping her in, and yes! Yes! They've accepted! It's time for the Dracula Ant Fusion. This is my favorite part of keeping ants, designing what they will call their homelands. I take an ant hour or two or three to be connected with vinyl tubing so we can see them travel to and from these cleformicariums. I take some soil and pack some into them. I love designing habitats for creatures like our neat ant towers, naturalistic for Dracula ants. Just like this. Now here's my tip for landscaping a space. Just take your time, this isn't like a race. Just keep your tallest decorations at the back and smaller at the sides and smallest at the front, looks great! Just like this. I want the ants to love this space, so I try to mimic their natural habitat. Kind of like this. I just love decorating for my ants. Just a few touches now. And now I think my landscaping's complete. What do you think? Don't these ant farms look neat? The next step is how to get the new Dracula ant colony to move from their container into this. And so I had to move the new colony into the new ant towers. And so this is what I did. I took them and I moved them over an outworld to expose them delicately. I spilled the contents into the outworld to encourage them out. My plan was to try to scoop them, these ants running around in the open, and place them into these ant towers anew. And don't forget that brood, we need them moved too. And somewhere in here there was a gamma gate, a fertile worker who laid all the eggs. I don't think I'd be able to spot the gamma gate, but I know she's in here. What will end up happening is the gamma gates of these two colonies will wrestle until one ends up as the reigning dominant and sole gamma gate of the super colony. She will be the one to lay all the eggs from henceforward. Pretty neat stuff. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for. It was time to officially make our two Dracula ant colonies one. Night of the Dracula ants, such suspense watching them. I'm still scared that they would fight. Night of the Dracula ants, in a trance so intense, I watched this whole scene wide-eyed. Night of the Dracula ants, exploring their new lands, as one ant approached, I died. Night of the Dracula ants, wow, it seemed no problems, the two colonies unified. Night of the Dracula ants, they were one, they would dance at their blood festival, what a sight. Night of the Dracula ants made me realize I had the power to manipulate life. Night of the Dracula ants, no babies, no chemolymph, they would celebrate by drinking new blood. Night of the Dracula ants, it's so gross and twisted, but somehow it felt so good. Night of the Dracula ants, there was no aggression, just a meeting of two vampire tribes. Night of the Dracula ants, they became a single clan, there was no stopping these vampires. Night of the Dracula ants, we succeeded this attempt to strengthen their worker force. Night of the Dracula ants, they were stronger, they would win any battle, any war, any fight. Night of the Dracula ants, they would thrive in their dance, blood sucking their siblings' blood. Night of the Dracula ants, a full moon in the lands, they mix like I knew they would. Night of the Dracula ants, I would watch over them to help them keep on growing. Night of the Dracula ants, throw a root in for them, feast my vampiric children. Night of the Dracula ants, now I fully understand why I love bankkeeping so much. Night of the Dracula ants made me realize I had the power to manipulate life. Yes, our plan worked. Yes, these ants were One super colony of vampires! And finally, AC family, I'm pleased to present to you the completed new Blood Towers. Isn't it just magical? All the ants were living harmoniously together. Ants were busy digging new tunnels in the new sections of the tower. And this Dracula ant super colony now had access to a legit outworld where they could hunt like a pack of wolves for prey to bring home, to feed to their babies so they could feast on their blood. So now they're living within this dimension. I mention this corner of YouTube land within the Antiverse, full of kingdoms of epic colonies of ants. AC family, but hold on now. There's something else I must show. There has been a big change inside one of the ant kingdoms. It's the Golden Empire. I'm sorry, I'll show you next week. Alright, AC family, did you enjoy this week's Halloween musical episode? If there were any songs in particular that you enjoyed, I have left the timestamps to all the tracks in the description box, so you could jump back to your favorites if you want to hear them again. It was a lot of fun to write and record. Also guys, a huge change happened in the Golden Empire's kingdom, the Hacienda del Dorado, and you may be shocked. So, hit the subscribe button and bell icon now so you don't miss out on next week's episode on one of our OG ant colonies of the Antiverse. Hit the like button every single time, including now. By the way, the ant towers you saw featured in this video are now officially available at AntsCanada.com. Do feel free to pick one up and start ant keeping with me. If you need ants, you can see if there's a seller in your area in the Queen Ants for Sale section, also on our website. If you're new to the channel and want to catch up on all your AntsCanada lore, feel free to binge watch this complete storyline playlist here, which traces the origins of all the ant colonies of the Ant Room, so you can follow their stories and better appreciate how these ant kingdoms came to be and why we love them so much. AC Inner Colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here if you would just like to watch extended play footage of the Dracula ants living in their new blood towers. And before we proceed to the AC question of the week, I'd like to plug my daily vlogging channel, Daily Vlogs, which have become a full-out bird dad channel, as I am now raising a baby African gray parrot. If you love birds, I'd love for you to meet my new cute little bird. Hope you can subscribe when you're there. And now it's time for the AC question of the week. Last week we asked, why did we have to cover the nest of these free-roaming ants ASAP after discovering them? Congratulations to Doodle Art Draw, who correctly answered, you had to cover the ants ASAP because you were scared that they were going to abandon their home. Congratulations, Doodle Art Draw, you just won a free ebook handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, name one reason why having a large colony is advantageous in the ant world. Leave your answer in the comment section and you could also win a free ebook handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's Ant Love forever.